Hello and welcome to Physiology Open. The excitability of nerve is studied using two properties, chronaxy and rheobase, which are determined by plotting strength duration curve. For plotting this curve, we need to stimulate the nerve with an electrical stimulus. When the stimulus is of threshold intensity, the nerve responds by generation of an action potential which can be recorded. Now, when we deliver a stimulus, basically, we are delivering some charge to the tissue. Charge will change the potentials, and if the charge quantity is enough, the potential change will reach the threshold. This is known as threshold stimulus. And since charge is equal to current into time, any stimulus has two features. That is a stimulus strength and the other the duration for which it is given. Now you see, same amount of charge can be delivered by changing either the current or the time. So suppose I have to deliver a strength of say 40 charge to generate a threshold stimulus. We are just taking some arbitrary numbers here, so please forgive me for units and all, okay? Anyways, for a charge of 40, either I can keep the current as 2 and time as 20, or 4 into 10, or maybe 5 into 8, or 10 into 4, and so on. So same charge can be delivered by multiple combinations of current amount and duration. Fundamentally, if a stimulus strength is kept more, the duration for which it needs to be given is kept less, and if strength is less, duration is more. We represent this stimulus by this kind of diagram, where height represents the strength of current and plateau represents the duration. So now let's see the strength duration graph of a nerve. So in this graph, x-axis shows the stimulus duration while y-axis shows the stimulus strength. Now this graph represents all the stimulus strength and stimulus duration combinations which will produce a response in nerve. You can notice here that as we decrease the stimulus strength, duration for which it is given is increasing, same as what we have discussed earlier. This occurs to a point that if the stimulus strength is kept this much, just below this strength, no matter how long it is given, it does not generate an action potential. Why does it happen? Remember, some charge always leaks through the membrane due to leaky channels. So if we give very small current for very large duration, that small amount of current has ample time to leak through the membrane, and hence it never causes the potential to reach the threshold. Or one may argue that if you increase the duration for unlimited time, that is infinite time, it may lead to generation of action potential. So this current strength, which needs to be given for infinite time to generate an action potential, is known as rheobase. But in practical terms, is it really possible to give a current for infinite duration? Will you wait till infinity to get that one value? So in practical terms, it is generally considered that minimum current strength, which given for 300 millisecond duration produces an action potential, is rheobase. Minimum because if you use above this strength, obviously lesser time will be required. Below this strength, it will not produce any action potential. And the time for which the rheobase is given is known as utilization time. Now, as already told, that practically it's very difficult to know true rheobase. So what we do is, instead of rheobase, we determine something known as chronaxy. Chronaxy is the duration for which double the strength of rheobase current will produce an action potential. So we get an approximate rheobase, say here, double its strength, so it will be till here, and chronaxy is duration for which this strength is given. So we just extend this line to the graph, drop a perpendicular and see how much duration is needed. So this much duration is chronaxy. So why do we want to know all this? You will understand it better if I show you graphs of two different nerves. By seeing this graph, can you tell which represents a more excitable nerve, A or B? You can pause the video and think about the answer before moving on. Okay, here B represents more excitable tissue. See, if for any particular duration, we check the strength of current required. So I will draw a line from here to the graphs, and then draw a line from here to the current required. So we see that here B requires less strength. So obviously, lesser charge is excitatory to B, and hence it is more excitable. In simple terms, compared to B, A is having more rheobase and chronaxy. This happens in nerve injuries. When a nerve is injured, it becomes less excitable and the stent duration curve shifts rightwards and outwards. And if we follow it up with recovery of the nerve, excitability improves and the curve gradually shifts towards normal. Well, thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, do press the like and share button. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel Physiology Open. Thank you.